things happen in their program, but they picked up a couple D1 transfers. Anytime you can pick up a D1 transfer, they can make an immediate impact at this level.
Non-conference schedule here to begin the year, before you hit that Cascade conference schedule, you got some highlights, which include some NCAA Division III schools, Willamette and Linfield, and a trip to Florida this year. What are some highlights for you on the schedule non-conference wise?
Well, I think the girls are just looking forward to Florida, but we have a lot of games to be playing before we get to Florida, and I hope they remember we're going there to play basketball, not play around in Disney World too much. But I think we have a great preseason conference. Some are real difficult games. Actually, this weekend we open up with probably one of the toughest opponents on our preseason schedule in Montana Tech. They went to the national tournament last year. They returned everyone but one player. They had one senior. So it's going to be a tough test this weekend. But I think it's a good combination that we could hopefully have some success if we put some things together, but also we'll be challenged. I want to win preseason games. I want to win every game, and the girls want to win every game. But I also want to make sure come conference time, and especially down the stretch of conference time, we're prepared and we step up our game and we're playing our best ball then, not necessarily in the end of October.
Yeah, we'll talk a little about this game here on Saturday. You begin the season at 2:30 p.m. Regular season begins at Coin Coliseum against Montana Tech. And I know you kind of joked around, like, gee, can we cancel this game? It's so early. A different schedule game for you. But let's talk about the Ore Diggers and what they're bringing.
Yeah. When I made that comment, it's not that, obviously I don't want to play Montana or we're intimidated to play Montana. They're just really quality. And I believe in giving respect to those who deserve it. And Montana Tech has built, Carrie's done a great job there in the last couple of years building that program. And it is going to be a tough test because it is still in October. You play basketball in November, play basketball December, January, and February, and March. You don't necessarily play it at the end of October, but, we schedule it, and we'll be ready to go. But they're big. They're quite the opposite of us. We're little. They're big. They're nice and long. I mean, their guards are 5'11", 5'10". They can jump out of the gym. They got a couple big girls that can move well. They'll pressure us. I mean, they'll probably pressure us the most that any team in the preseason will pressure us. So it would be a great test and teachable moment to our young kids. So, a lot of good things will come out of the game, win or lose. Now, obviously, we're going in thinking we can compete with them. We competed with them well on the road last year, and I feel we can compete with them this weekend as well.
Well, Coach, we wish you the best of luck, not only this weekend but all season, and appreciate you coming by. Looking forward to it.
Thanks, Ray.
No problem. And our final guest today, Head Coach Isaac Williams from the men's basketball program. And again, that'll be a 2:30 tip-off on Saturday at Coin Coliseum as the Eastern Oregon University women play against Montana Tech. There'll be a live video stream of that on EOUSports.com. And I think Paul Carollo and a rumor that possibly Isaac Williams will be doing the calling of the game on Saturday. I don't know if Isaac's heard that yet.
That is definitely a rumor.
That's definitely a rumor. It's funny because that's what Paul let me know. We'll see what happens.
We will see.
All right. I don't want to put that word out there. But, Coach, your preseason poll comes out tomorrow. But let's go ahead and talk, same kind of question to you. You had Midnight Madness last Wednesday, and you also had your alumni game on Saturday. What's good for your program about those two events, and what do you look from as a coach about those?
Well, you want to see how your kids are going to respond to playing with the lights on, and it's Midnight Madness is great. It's more of a time for your guys to meet some of the people in the community that are going to support them, and vice versa. Time for the community and the students to go see your team and what they might have a chance to see during the course of the year. It's a good time, it's loose. Now, the alumni game we take a little more seriously because it's the first time you can get some officiating. You can see how you can play around with your lineups and your rotations, but it's fun. It's great. The kids love it because they're sick of playing each other basically every day in practice.
Some of those newcomers really looked impressive in that alumni game. I know it's always hard to look at an alumni game and say, well, these are things we did great because it's against a bunch of guys who don't really play together. But, some of those newcomers this year, you got a whole list. Talk a little bit about those guys.
Well, I hate to put, you know, this is a hard time for me because I like to look at our team as just that, a team, you know. I don't like the term key newcomers or key losses. I mean, they're all key to me. Everybody who played and everybody who will play plays an important role in your program.
You're so politically correct.
But, you know, to me, I honestly think we have a great class of kids coming in. We have a great group of people coming back. But there's a lot of things to be determined. You know, we need to see how we'll do.
Two returners is the next question.
We need to see how we're going to deal with adversity and stuff like that. But not on an individual level, but as a unit, the kids we brought in, I'm very excited about. How about that?
Yeah, that works well. Now, Cascade Comics Bowl again comes out tomorrow. You know, there's some teams that have been talked about. Northwest, the team who's going to be a lot different, a lot more experienced. You know, Oregon Tech, you always got to mention them, Warner Pacific. What's that conference race going to be about this year?
Well, you know, every year we say it's going to be really tough, and I'm proud to say that the Cascade Conference is one of, if not the best, conference in men's basketball in the NAIA Division II. And this year will be no different. It'll be very tough. There's a lot of uncertainty early because the top four teams had some turnover on their roster. And so there's a lot of newcomers, ourselves included. Warner Pacific was third behind us, and they have basically a whole new team that looks pretty good. Oregon Tech lost four starters who won the league, of course. And then Northwest, who you mentioned, who was fifth, tied for fourth, actually, but lost the tiebreak, has everybody back. So they're the one team in the conference that looks to be returning a lot of people, which is an important, intangible thing to have.
Now, if you look at the schedule, non-conference, you guys are not going to Florida. But you do have some pretty big games, a trip to Carroll College for a tournament and a trip to Whitman College for a tournament. You know, some highlights for you on your non-conference schedule.
We traded in our chance to go to Florida to go to Helena, Montana. I heard it's beautiful during that time of the year.
It's quite similar.
It would be about 20 degrees and lots of snow, but it's actually a nice day. For us, the preseason, it's hard to get home games, you know, because where we are geographically, we don't really have like a natural group of teams that people will come play and get a couple of games. So we have to play a lot on the road, and this year is no different. We'll be out there. We play in Portland a couple times. We'll play in Walla Walla in the Whitman tournament. We play in Helena, which you mentioned in that tournament. We'll be all over the place except for in LeGrand.
Now, Coach, you're going to be here every Tuesday at noon, hopefully. Next time, I'd appreciate it if when I wear a sweater and a collared shirt, you don't try to outdress me again. Because I like to be the showcase on this one.
Well, you're always the show every time, but no disrespect.
Next week, we'll talk a little bit about the men's first games, October 29th and 30th at Portland Bible and Multnomah University. But, Coach, thanks for coming by.
Hey, thanks for having me.
So, again, 29th and 30th, men's basketball will kick off. We'll go ahead and talk a little bit about some headlines on EOUsports.com. 30 golf teams, a record number at last week, Les Schwab Scholarship Scramble, Mark Avery Earhart, and Kedrick Starr, both named Players of the Week. Mark Avery Earhart was the Frontier Conference Defensive Player of the Week, and Kedrick Starr was named the Victory Sports Network National Special Teams Player of the Week. And that's pretty much going to do it. Looking at the calendar real quick, it'll be the cross-country meet in Caldwell, Idaho on Thursday at 5 p.m. And then Friday, the women's soccer team will be at Northwest Christian. And 7 p.m. that night, volleyball will be at home. And then on Saturday, football at 1 p.m. at Carroll College at 1 p.m. Mountain Time. And soccer on the road at Corbin. And then at home, 7 p.m. volleyball on Saturday night. Again, every Tuesday here at Benchwarmers Pub and Grill. At noon, come down, check out the lunch specials, and appreciate everyone for watching, and have a good week.